Welcome to Breaking News Today. The like button, and if you're new, make sure they hit that subscribe button down below and turn on my post.
Fired. One Democrat is facing an ethics sanction. Libs can't believe their eyes. You would surmise that subsidiary with the media would understand that with the present condition of the web, that keeping a top on stories is practically inconceivable. One basic tweet and the ugly truth is out in the open as sites illuminate with the news, regardless of the possibility that it is very theoretical. That the story may not be right or have been misshaped is insignificant. It will get free, and once that occurs there is no returning it in the jug. Stories with sexual hints, particularly those including big names, are extremely unpredictable. Individuals appear to desire this sort of news, so the web, as of now an effective power for spreading news and chatter, goes into hyper-role over such disclosures. Best to fess up and attempt to get really out there than to leave the web to its own with the unavoidable contortions and hypotheses that will be spread. Democratic attorney David Boies evidently doesn't comprehend this, as he attempted to put a cover on the Harvey Weinstein story while his law office was working for the New York Times. Clearly, he fizzled. How might anybody expect something else? Anyway, the NIT has ended its association with Mr. Boies' law office, something that shouldn't come as a lot of a shock either. Mainstream media outlets, for example, the New York Times, positively require no assistance in depicting the picture that they are basically mouthpieces for the left. This is an acknowledged actuality among conservatives and has helped start the fake news allegations that have been heaved at media firms, for example, CNN. That these assaults have stuck is a measure of the disappointment conservatives have had with a news industry that is overpowering one-sided against their political perspectives. The New York Times dismissed the firm of famed Democratic lawyer David Boies after Ronan Farrow's explosive report for The New Yorker put Boies at the center of Harvey Weinstein's efforts to stamp out the Times' reporting on his sexual misconduct. "We never contemplated that the law firm would contract with an intelligence firm to conduct a secret spying operation aimed at our reporting and our reporters," the Times wrote in a Tuesday statement announcing they would no longer work with Boies's firm, Boies, Schiller and Flexner. "Such an operation is reprehensible. Mr. Boies and his law office have just exacerbated the situation," something the NIT has conceded. "So we have a law office controlled by Democrats, attempting to advance Democratic causes. Up until this point, nothing amiss with that. At that point, one of the principals of the law office stepped over the line by attempting to control the arrival of news by one of its customers, the New York Times." Monday, immediately after Farrow's piece broke, the New York Times issued a statement aghast at Boies, Schiller and Flexner's conduct, reading, "We learned today that the law firm of Boies, Schiller and Flexner secretly worked to stop our reporting on Harvey Weinstein at the same time as the firm's lawyers were representing us in other matters. We consider this intolerable conduct, a grave betrayal of trust, and a breach of the basic professional standards that all lawyers are required to observe. It is inexcusable and we will be pursuing appropriate remedies." As the Times must know, this kind of disclosure just draws in more claims that the paper is a purveyor of fake news, or for this situation, no news in the event that it influences Democrats to look terrible. The inquiry remains what, assuming any, move the Times will make against Boies and his law office. There's a reasonable moral violation here. What's more, what Boies did has done nothing to help the notoriety of the daily paper. On the off chance that anything, it just affirmed what many as of now accept is a reality. The greater inquiry is whether the Times will ever have the capacity to build up itself as a reliable source. Not to be cynical, but rather without a noteworthy possession change and an enormous shakeup inside the paper, it's suspicious. What do you think about this? Do not hesitate and write your thoughts in the comment section below.